Blackstone presents Winter's Mage by Miriam Greystone. This book is read by Erica Sullivan. For Josh, this is my beloved and this is my friend. Shur HaShurim, chapter 5, verse 16. Prologue. It turns out that, in the aftermath of being attacked by a clan of bloodthirsty mages out for carnage and revenge, centaurs can get a little bit twitchy. "You are being ridiculous and you have to stop," I told Crinia, who pawed at the ground with apparent frustration as she glared at me. Smaller than the average centaur, what she lacked in stature she made up for with the ferocity of her expression. She stood with her long brown braids flung over her shoulder and the creamy tan horse-like portion of her body practically dancing with frustration. I set down the heavy armful of books I had been collecting and crossed my arms over my own chest, mirroring her stance, trying to make it clear that I had no intention of backing down. "I opened this clinic years before we ever had centaur guards here. We can certainly make it through one night on our own." My eyes flicked over to Jason, who sat on a nearby tabletop, swinging his legs back and forth and watching our exchange with wide eyes. He seemed determined to do the smart thing and stay out of this conversation. "I'm just saying that you might enjoy spending the night in the safety of the centaur camp," Crinia said, her tone a bit too sharp to sound cajoling, her eyes flashing. "I don't understand why you won't consider coming. I wouldn't be allowed to attend your super secret centaur ritual, right? The one that even the clinic guards have to be at?" Crinia hesitated before giving a grudging nod. "So I would be coming to the camp in order to spend the night sitting all by myself, doing nothing, sleeping on the ground instead of in my own bed, and generally wondering what in the world I had been thinking when I accepted your invitation?" "Not on the ground," Crinia responded coolly. "We have straw." I huffed out a sigh of exasperation and threw my hands up in the air. Jason seemed to realize things were getting out of hand. He hopped down from the table and came to stand beside me. "I know you were pretty shaken up by what happened, Crinia," he said, his tone placating. "We all were." Crinia's brow wrinkled. "Shaken?" She peered at Jason with an expression that betrayed no small degree of concern for his mental well-being. "No one has shaken me. Should anyone try to shake me up, I assure you his head would roll at my feet as soon as he laid a hand upon me." Jason's response caught in his throat, and he coughed, his face flushing pink. I couldn't be sure if he was choking down a chuckle or if Crinia's words had simply surprised him. Having seen her behead an enemy before, I didn't feel particularly inclined to laughter. "What I mean to say," he continued after regaining control of himself, "is that Amy's foster mother, Mary, is back in charge of the Mage clan. She's incredibly powerful, the most powerful mage in the world, according to Amy. And Mary is making sure that none of the mages come after Amy anymore. All of that is over now." Crinia cocked a disbelieving eyebrow at Jason and then swiveled her head around to frown at me. "Your actions have angered an exceptionally powerful group of people, have they not?" "Yes, but—" "And these people have already tried to kill you on multiple occasions?" "Well, yes, but that was all while Mary was imprisoned. She's free now." "Being free is not the same thing as being firmly back in power." Crinia's hooves clicked against the wooden floorboards. "Your foster mother was weakened by being held captive for many long years, and after you rescued her, she completely used up the pearl, her great reservoir of power, to save herself from death and at least partially repair your own injuries." Crinia's eyes flicked to the wound that still lingered on my chest. "Who is to say she can fully control the actions of all the mages who wish to do you harm?" I didn't have a good answer. Jason's eyes darkened, and I knew before he spoke that he had started to waver.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.